major influence on one's purchasing habits and consumer behavior is the social class. The social class is hard to define. Usually, however, people are grouped in social classes according to their income, wealth, education, or type of occupation. Perhaps the simplest model to define social class is a three-tiered approach that includes the rich, the middle class, and the poor. People in the same social classes tend to have similar attitudes, live in similar neighborhoods, dress alike, and shop at the same type of stores. Even have a good time. Everybody looks to their left. Everybody looks to their right. Can you feel that? Yeah, we're paying with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just want to make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching. Ain't about the, yeah, bubbling, bubbling. Want to make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Okay. We need to take it back in time. When music made us all unite. And it wasn't low blows and video hoes. Am I the only one getting tired? French sociologist Pierre Bourdieu coined the term habitus. It was to describe a social property of individuals that orients human behavior without strictly determining it. While it encompasses a sense of practical expertise, it is not a conscious expertise. Rather, it may be seen as common sense. For example, every day we put on clothing. While we may think about what to wear, we don't think whether or not we will wear something. Andrew Martinez from the University of California, Berkeley, engaged in a practice of public nudity in 1990 that sought to challenge the basic habitus of getting dressed or not at all. Millennials are now breaking the old adage that first comes love and then comes marriage. These days, it's more like first comes college, a good job, maybe a house and a savings account, and then can we talk about marriage? Some experts argue that marriage itself is contributing to the rising inequality among the social classes, because people who are highly educated and therefore have higher income potential are more likely to choose people of their same social circle. And that refers to homogamy. Apart from the natural differences, human beings are also differentiated according to the socially approved criteria. Socially differentiated men are treated as socially unequal from the point of view of enjoyment of social rewards. Rewards like power, status, income, and education. And that is called social inequality. The term simply refers to the existence of socially created inequalities. One form of inequality is social stratification. All societies arrange their members in terms of superiority, inferiority, and equality. Stratification is a process of interaction or differentiation whereby some people come to rank higher than others. From the word strata, meaning layers, it literally means layers of the society. Members with a common identity or have a similar lifestyle belong to one layer.
Okay, coconut man, moon heads, and tea. You ready? Seems like everybody's got a price. I wonder how they sleep at night. When the sale comes first and the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious? Acting so damn mysterious. Got shades on your eyes and your...
No, it's not a tattoo on their arm or any part of their body. They could be identified with their respective status symbols. Status symbols refer to the function of culture to exhibit social class. That is, whereas cultural capital pertains to the individual's appreciation of culture, symbolic pertains to the way in which the appreciation sends the signal to others. So when a person is seen to exhibit tastes and preferences, others see the car they drive, the clothes they wear, the things they eat, and the places they go. Their possession and consumption of cultural products convey an expression of their social class. One thing I know about consumer behavior is that it doesn't remain the same. A different approach is different for every situation. Why is that? Why, my friends? It's because of the demographics. And if those demographics changes, consumer behavior also changes. And that is where demographic analysis enters. So for example, ethnic demographics include the low class, middle class, upper class, and the minority group everywhere, I mean everywhere, have traditionally received less education, fewer cultural opportunities, and earned lower incomes than the other classes. The condition of such people are no doubt changing, but still the consumption pattern of the minority group people remain the same.